Hello and welcome to NHL Network's countdown of the top 40 moments in Stanley Cup history. I'm Kelly Nash. Lord Stanley's Cup is unlike any other trophy in sports. Champions' names are engraved on the chalice, and each year it's passed down to the next title winner. We start our countdown at number 40 with Game 5 of the 2014 Finals.
Brassard trying to stagger free. Meanwhile, it's played along to him. Centering pass flagged down by Green. Played into traffic, though. Starting back up with it now is Martinez in a 3-on-2. Clifford gave it across. It's held in a shot. Safe.
Martinez scored the OT winner in Game 7 in the Western Conference Finals against the Chicago Blackhawks. And he does it again to win the Stanley Cup.
I just saw there's a hello loose puck in my own end, and I just tried to get it in the forward's hands. I think Toffoli had a great shot for our pad, and fortunately the rebound came to me and I was able to put it in.
The 1928 Stanley Cup Finals featured the Montreal Maroons and the New York Rangers, who were making their first finals appearance. During Game 2 of the series, an eye injury forced the Rangers' starting goalie out of the game, and he would not return. Head coach and general manager Lester Patrick inserted himself into the game in relief. Patrick saved 18 of 19 shots as the Rangers won 2-1 in overtime. And they would eventually go on to win the series 3-2 in a best of five format. At over 44 years old, Patrick is and still remains the oldest player to ever play in a Stanley Cup Finals game.
Scott Stevens saw Scott Gomez. And his pass is easily picked off by Correa, who got it back in. Sakura lost it going in, and flattened at the line was Correa. He is hurt.
Scott Stevens. Got Correa cutting across the rink as Correa passed the puck to his left and then watched the pass a little too long. And we have seen Scott Stevens do this before. He doesn't know where he is, Correa. He's more than winded by the look of it.
There's Paul Correa back on the bench. He shakes it off. Boy, he took a hard one, though. Did he not? Wow. Now the other way. This is a record. Correa! A few minutes ago, comes back, and oh baby, look at this shot.
You don't see many goals in the NHL scored like this.
New Jersey, but this baby is a 5-2 win for the Ducks.
Paul Correa's return after that awful wallop he took from Scott Stevens, I think, was the deciding factor in this game.
The first team to win two cups in this century.
This would mark the third Stanley Cup title for the New Jersey Devils since the 1994-95 season. In the four games played on home ice, Devils goaltender Martin Brodeur recorded three shutouts, including the pivotal do-or-die Game 7. Brodeur stopped all 24 shots sent his way in Game 7, including 10 shots in the final period.
Less than a minute remaining. Esposito races to the bench in Chicago, sends six men into the Canadian zone. Pete Mihaljevic clears the puck down ice. Only seconds remain. Here comes Mikita. Over to Martin. He loses control, and the puck comes out of the Montreal end. And the game is over. Canadians have won the Stanley Cup for a record 16th time.
Game 7 of the 1971 Stanley Cup Finals was played in Chicago, yet the road team, the Montreal Canadiens, came away victorious. Even more remarkable was the Canadiens overcoming a 2-0 series deficit en route to winning their third title in 4 years.
Here's a chance for Chalios. He steps in. Chalios coming in. Oh, the pass to Lemieux. He missed it. Penalty is over, and the Flames, four of them get out. Up to center, and coming in is Lou. Hewitt-Dyke centered it. McDonald scores! Matty McDonald!
And McDonald showed you a 26-year-old shot by a 36-year-old man as he put it up and over Patrick Waugh.
Waugh made the move. McDonald fired it high. 2-1 Calgary. He just came out of the penalty box.
Here comes the siren. Here come the flames. Champions. 1989. The Stanley Cup has been won by Calgary.
We have more moments to count down after the break, including a wonderful goal by one of hockey's all-time greats. Stay tuned.
Mario Lemieux, and he is off, racing in all alone. Lemieux, his first shot on goal, and he scores! Mario Lemieux, living up quickly to all the advertisement on his first shot on goal. Walks in on Pete Peters, puts on a deke, leaves Peters out to dry.
Mario Lemieux is one of hockey's all-time greats. Inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1997, Lemieux won two Stanley Cups during his magnificent career, and he makes our countdown at number 34.
Murphy back, he missed it. Minnesota on and right in front of again, Barrasso. Had to be good to stop Barrasan. Here's Lemieux, the center penalty coming up. Look at Lemieux! Oh my heavens! What a goal! What a move! Lemieux!
Folks at home are joining the crowd here for a standing ovation for one of the prettiest goals you'd ever want to see. Very few could ever make this play like Mario Lemieux to put his team up 3-1. One against the world, and he dekes the whole world on it here. Beautiful is the only word to describe that play by number 66.
Holy cow! What a goal by Mario Lemieux.
1952 was a historic year for the Detroit Red Wings. The Wings won 8 straight playoff games, beating the Toronto Maple Leafs and then the Montreal Canadiens to win the Stanley Cup Final. It was also during this run of victories that an infamous tradition was born. As the legend goes, two Detroit men threw an octopus onto the ice during the fourth and final game of the Stanley Cup Finals. The 8 tentacles are a symbol of the 8 victories it took Detroit to win the championship. And the good luck charm has stuck ever since.
Allowing 8 goals in the first 6 games, it makes you think, how can this series be tied with the way he played?
15 seconds. They are celebrating on the Boston bench as Thomas steers this one aside. Zdeno Chara able to clear it up the far boards. Will it go far enough for icing? It will not. For the 6th time in the storied history of the Boston Bruins, they are Stanley Cup champions.
It was the 6th Stanley Cup title for Boston, their first since 1972. Goalie Tim Thomas was spectacular, recording 37 saves and a shutout in Game 7 on the road. During Boston's run, Thomas set the NHL record for saves in a postseason and saves in a Stanley Cup series. He was named Conn Smythe Trophy winner as the MVP of the 2011 playoffs. Game 4 of the 1988 Finals was bizarre to say the least. with temperatures upwards of 80 degrees inside the Boston Garden. A thick fog developed over the ice. But this was only the beginning.
Goal came just in time for the Edmonton Oilers to tie the game, because now, Harry just said, the lights have gone out here in the Boston Garden. Now all we see are one or two emergency lights and a series of flash bulbs all over the building. We're recording this the night the lights went out in the Boston Garden.
And in this hot, steamy Boston Garden, we are at about 20% of the normal lighting. Teams have gone to the dressing room. The referees have gone to their dressing room. And they're trying to find out if they can fix the situation.
The building wasn't confident that they could resume its power without a failure later on tonight. So that tonight's game had to be called off.
A stick measurement has been called. It's the stick of Marty McSorley.
Marty McSorley. If he uses an illegal stick, which he did, and there's no excuse for that.
1:45 remaining in the third, and the Canadians have six skaters against four. Muller back of the net with it. Blake in there, hit his man. Desjardins ready. Schneider ready. Desjardins, no shot. On the outside, Desjardins shot, goal! Canadians trying to get it out. Carboneau does. Two of them. Ronan coming up there. Brunet carries in. Ronan in front of the net. And a shot. Desjardins following the play. And he missed it. The short side. Here he is again. Scores. Desjardins. And the Canadians win in overtime. His third goal of the game. And the series is a brand new one.
Schneider and Curry lead their team with shots. Six each. Lehman and Suchak are the only two forwards in the game that don't have one.
That's Hardy getting center ice and shooting it in. Leclerc will pick it up and come out for Montreal, out to center. Long shot by Bellows, didn't get too far. Here's a chance for Leclerc! Oh, and a roll by the open side. He got another crack at it, he scores! The Canadians win the game in overtime again. This time, very early, 34 seconds. The Canadians won it.
Well, they have just done something no other team in Stanley Cup history has ever done, win nine consecutive overtime games. They shared that record with the New York Islanders, and Harry, they've done it in 1 year. That's incredible.
More memorable Stanley Cup moments after the break, including a couple game winners you need to see to believe. Welcome back to NHL Network's countdown of the top 40 moments in Stanley Cup history. The 1942 Toronto Maple Leafs stand alone in history. After falling behind the Detroit Red Wings 3-0, the Maple Leafs made a comeback for the ages, winning the next three games to force a Game 7. Toronto then defeated Detroit 3-1 in the series finale to claim the Stanley Cup, their fourth in franchise history.
2-for-4 on the power play for the Lightning, 0-for-3. Calgary. Same way, puts the hit on. Leopold in the corner, got it out of there. Moved it up the wall. Tullamore went down. Taylor the shot. Redirected. Score! Game 7! Montan St. Louis! We are going back to Tampa Bay! 33 seconds into the double overtime!
He heads off. We're 4-on-4. Once he gets to the bench, Calgary will have the advantage. They do right now. Running out of time now, 4 seconds left. In front, Harry Roland, the Tampa Bay Lightning have won the first Stanley Cup!
This is more than I ever unexpected. You can dream about it, but you can't really go through it. And it's been an unbelievable ride.
We're in the Stanley Cup final for the second year in a row. And here's Jágr with the puck. Jágr, nice move around Brent Sutter to the backhand. Let's it go. He scores!
Well, this is the one thing that team defense cannot defend against. Great individual efforts. He beat one guy, Dirk Graham, then a second player. Now he's going to beat a third Hawk and make him look bad. And I don't care how good the team is defensively as a team, that becomes man on man. And Jágr just beat three of them.
17 seconds remaining. Pittsburgh has the man advantage in a 4-4 tie. What a game to start this series. Game one of the best of seven. And the Stanley Cup final, and here we go. 1-for-5 of the power play tonight. And love one here. There's a shot. Score! Mario Lemieux! And he scores!
What a comeback by Pittsburgh. They looked down and out and almost buried when they were down 4-1.
Kane moves by a couple, steps in and shot one, turned aside. To the bench is Crawford, extra attacker out in the net empty. They battle in the corner, hits finesse by Keith around for a feed in front. Score! Tage to Bickle with 1:16 to go in the third. Here's one thrown by Brolik that's blocked away by Rath. Help to the back. Oduya shot deflected, scramble! They score! Less than a minute to go. Two goals in 17 seconds from a 2-1 deficit, a 3-2 lead. And the puck bounced out the center. Striding ahead for it is Tate. Staggering on Tate. Pushed it wide. 2 seconds and one. The Blackhawks are Stanley Cup champions.
Montreal Canadiens center Brian Skrudland scored 9 seconds into overtime to give the Canadiens the win in Game 2 of the 1986 Cup Finals. Skrudland's goal remains an NHL record for the quickest game winner in Stanley Cup overtime history. They went on to win the title in 5 games.
Well, often they say overtime games will end quickly. You can't get much quicker than 9 seconds. The final score in overtime, Montreal 3, Calgary 2.
Hurricanes dump it in. Wallin tried to kick it back along the board. And it's cleared by Lariana. Ahead now to Holmstrom. Holmstrom drops it back. Lariana coming in. Gets to the backhand. Play by Igor Larionov to end this game.
The 1951 Stanley Cup Final was filled with drama as the Toronto Maple Leafs defeated the Montreal Canadiens 4-1, with each game ending in overtime. It was in Game 5 that Leafs defender Bill Barilko scored the cup-winning goal, giving Toronto their 6th title in 10 years. Shortly after the season, however, Barilko died in a plane crash. Known as the curse of Bill Barilko, the Maple Leafs did not win another Stanley Cup title until the year the plane wreckage was found, 11 years later. After the break, we crack our countdown's top 20 moments, including a series clincher from Dallas. Stick around. It's been an up-and-down 2015-16 season for the Canadiens, but with 24 Stanley Cup championships in 34 appearances, it's safe to say their history and tradition is unmatched. Here's a look back at two of the greatest moments in Canadiens Cup history. 1958 saw the Montreal Canadiens continue their dominance over the hockey competition. Captain Maurice Richard found the net in overtime of Game 5 to give the Habs a 3-2 victory, swinging momentum in their favor. Montreal then won Game 6 in convincing fashion, 5-3, winning the Stanley Cup for the third consecutive year and 10th time in franchise history.
Lining up for the face-off. 2 seconds remaining. 4-0 in favor of Montreal. Stanley took a shot high off the glass. The bell goes. The game is over, and the Montreal Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup. 4-0. And this time they've set a record. For the fifth time, they are the champs. So you can't find anything more convincing than that.
Convincing is right. The Canadiens win their fifth consecutive Stanley Cup in the form of a 4-0 series sweep. The Habs finished with a perfect 8-0 playoff record, outscoring the Maple Leafs 15-5 in the championship series. The infamous fog game of 1975 appears on our countdown at number 18. The defending champion Philadelphia Flyers were taking on the Buffalo Sabres in what was the first Stanley Cup to feature two non-original six teams. Due to unusually high temperatures and a lack of indoor air conditioning, most of Game 3 was played under heavy fog. Tied 4-4, the game went to overtime, where Rene Roberts scored a game-winning goal for Buffalo, giving them their first win of the series. A week later, though, it was Philadelphia who won the series 4-2, hoisting their second consecutive Stanley Cup trophy.
Probably not what Pittsburgh wanted. It sets up another face-off situation here with 6.5 seconds remaining in Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals. Just that small amount of time separates the Pittsburgh Penguins from the third Stanley Cup in franchise history. Remember, they won back-to-back titles back in 91 and 92.
Off the tie-up. It comes back to the point. Rafalski, the shot. Knocked down in front. Scramble. There's that. Another shot. Another shot. Fought off by Fleury. The horn sounds and the Penguins have won the Stanley Cup.
Those last two saves were spectacular. One with the right pad, and then Fleury going over to stop another one just as the clock was ticking down.
Well, the Penguins have won their third Stanley Cup championship.
And New Jersey almost had a chance there, Dave, because Manson was left coming on the ice. Cole had a block. Gets it back to the ball.
Get the puck to the net, get people going to the net, and that's all Brett Hull tried to do. And Modano just took off, went straight to the net, and redirected that puck through the goaltender, Martin Brodeur, to end this thing. And there will be a game six in Dallas.
Damage foul. Good news for him. Stevens winds up, takes it. One wide. Boy, they got a couple screens. The Devils did it. Punt. That's the point. Stevens stepped up to hold it in. Stole it. Stevens holds it in again. Shot it right through the top of the crease. And he set a shot! Score! The New Jersey Devils have won the Stanley Cup! Jason Adden with the game-winning overtime goal!
Oh! Finally, the ending of the movie. The Devils win Game 6. The Devils of New Jersey have won the Stanley Cup.
Face off in the lead zone to the right. The Red Wings get the Drysdale Victor shot, hit Brewer. Here's Doug Bankley's drive, and that goes into the crowd, over the glass. Bob Bond. Lying down.
Well, he certainly is receiving a lot of attention from his teammates, and the way he fell so heavily seemed to indicate a collision.
Well, this big crowd of over 15,000, you can see them standing up and giving him a hand as they carry him off. They recognize a fellow that gives such tremendous service.
Langlois shifts it off the boards. Bob Bond lets it drive. It goes, scores! Bob Bond let it go. It bounced in front and went into the net.
it's all over. And the series is tied. And they'll play the seventh game Saturday night in Toronto.
Patrick Kane is a hockey superstar, and he appears next on our countdown with a Stanley Cup clincher for the ages. Keep it here on NHL Network.
Blackhawks number 88. He's going to drive right for Branson to the goalie. Bang!
Kane drops it to Taves.
He's
going to step into the offensive zone with a wrist shot.
Patrick Kane made his NHL debut in 2007. He's since taken the league by storm. Kane has a major flair for the dramatic, and we see exactly why with play number 13 on our countdown.
And around it's flicked by Ladd, and then went off of Coburn. On back to be taken by Campbell. Here's Campbell handing on to Kane again. Lots of head fakes there, trying to shake Demon. Threw it across the safe. Oh my, it rattled around. And it kicked on back, and it scored! We saw no light, we saw no signal, and we're not sure if they've set a signal of a goal yet, but they are celebrating at the other end of the ice. What chaos! Word has gotten to the Blackhawks what you have just seen. One of the more unusual finishes, but it's a goal. The Stanley Cup to the Chicago Blackhawks. No light, no signal just yet, but it is in fact over that line. And the Stanley Cup has been won by Chicago, as you see how this all happened. Well, why not? Why not a chaotic finish to all of this?
You think you know what it takes, but until you actually attain it, you have absolutely no idea.
Shoots it down the ice. Lott makes the save. Are deliriously happy here.
This is the arrival of the expansion team, the original expansion team. The Philadelphia should be a good omen for all of the other expansion clubs, from the players to their coaches to the management. But it can be done.
A chopping shot to the corner by Lemaire. Here's Marcotte again. Shot the Blues watching Sims. And LeFleur is going after it, right under the shoot, they score! Lemaire! And the Canadiens win the Stanley Cup!
The Montreal Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup, sweeping the Boston Bruins in four straight games. And in this, the deciding game, Jacques Lemaire has scored both Montreal goals. Now here we see it again, the pass that really counts comes out from behind as shut. Check Sims. Now Sims kicked it away right to LeFleur. And it's bang, bang to Lemaire as he picks the corner.
Jacques Lemaire scored three game-winning goals in the four-game series, including the series clincher. Lemaire played a huge part in the Canadiens winning their second consecutive Stanley Cup.
9 seconds, they count them down. The Detroit Red Wings have won the Stanley Cup 1998.
6 days after sweeping the Philadelphia Flyers to win the 1997 Stanley Cup, Red Wings defenseman Vladimir Konstantinov suffered severe brain and head injuries in a limousine crash. Konstantinov spent several weeks in a coma but survived, and it was clear that his playing days would end. The Red Wing team came back the following year and dedicated their season to Konstantinov, Detroit won the cup that year in a four-game sweep, and Konstantinov was wheeled onto the ice to celebrate with his teammates. Despite not playing a single game again for the Red Wings, Konstantinov's name would be engraved into the Stanley Cup from 1998. On the road and facing the end of their season, the Pittsburgh Penguins and Max Talbot came through. Talbot scored a game-tying goal with 34.3 seconds remaining in regulation, and it was in the third overtime that we have our number nine play on the countdown.
Whitney rifled it on across, fed back by Sikora to Gonchar. Sikora fires one, and that ricocheted off the referee. Right back to Sikora again, and it's shot. He scores! Sikora said he would get the winner, and he did! It's going back to Pittsburgh for a sixth game.
Got that right. He said it. I can't believe it. You talk about calling your shot. That is unbelievable. He called a shot.
He's had trouble shooting the puck. He's had trouble getting shots. But that one was a bullet by Tavares on the wrist shot.
Up from his defense post. Ran in the ball. There's going to be another penalty. But here is Sundin. Done it again. They were asking questions all over the place. What's wrong with Gretzky? I've got news for you. Nothing. There's a new foot on the block in the National Hockey League. The Edmonton Oilers. By name, the Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
It'll be Wayne Gretzky, as is the custom, the team captain.
Coming up, we've got goals galore and one of the longest games played in Stanley Cup history. You don't want to miss it.
Is it any better than this? I don't think so.
The Canadiens win the Stanley Cup.
A chance to lift the Stanley Cup over your head, every hockey player's dream.
The Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
The celebration is on in the Windy City.
The Penguins have won the Stanley Cup.
You win it once, you can't get enough.
The Blackhawks are Stanley Cup champions.
It's your honor to hoist the Stanley Cup.
Welcome back to NHL Network's countdown of the top 40 moments in Stanley Cup history. Game one of the 1990 Stanley Cup Finals would go down in history. A 2-2 tie was taken deep into the third overtime, and the hometown Boston fans could barely keep their eyes open. But it was Peter Klima who ended the longest game in Cup history.
5 minutes and 2 seconds left in the third overtime. And it's out over the line. McTavish and Curry. Klima catching up. He's in. She scores. Klima gets the goal for the Edmonton Oilers here in the third overtime at 15-13. And what a win this has got to be for the Edmonton Oilers.
You can see that Galley couldn't keep the puck in, and the Oilers broke away 3-on-2, and Klima found the short side to end this marathon with 4:47 left to go in the third overtime.
Young moving to the middle. Young, the shot, and it went off the glass high over the net. Now they try to clear. Get it up. In.
Get it on the net from the point. Maybe the goalie won't see it. And it doesn't look like Van Beesbrouck got a long look at that one. Just inside the right post.
and that goal gives the Stanley Cup to the Colorado Avalanche.
Uwe Krupp's unassisted goal ended over 44 minutes of overtime, giving the Colorado Avalanche the title. Goalie Patrick Waugh saved all 63 shots he faced for his third cup in 11 years. And Joe Sakic was named Conn Smythe Trophy winner as the playoff MVP, contributing 18 goals and 34 points in the postseason. Game 7 of the 2001 Stanley Cup Finals saw the Colorado Avalanche lead the New Jersey Devils 3-1. And with just 13 seconds left in the game, veteran Ray Bourque was on the verge of his first and only Stanley Cup.
Off the bench top into the corner. 10 seconds left to go. The countdown. Out of the zone. The Colorado gets a little Stanley Cup. Ray Bourque.
This team has so much heart, so much character. We kept it together, came back and won it at home. And all year long, we said home ice was going to be a key, and it turned out it was.
No player in history waited longer than Bourque to win his first Stanley Cup, playing 22 years with over 200 playoff games under his belt. Bourque would be inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2004. In Game 7 of the 1994 Finals, Captain Mark Messier scored a power play goal to give the New York Rangers a commanding 3-1 lead. It was the Rangers' first Stanley Cup appearance since 1979 and their 10th in team history. But with their sights set on ending a 54-year title drought, the city of New York was on edge.
This is the moment they have waited for a lifetime. 3-2 Rangers. The waiting is over. The New York Rangers are the Stanley Cup champions. And this one will last a lifetime.
No more 1940. It's gone. Congratulations, Rangers. The 1994 New York Rangers have done it. Let the celebration begin.
It's just emotional. You've dreamt about it. I dream about it. It's unbelievable.
The Dallas Stars won their first Stanley Cup in franchise history, outlasting the Buffalo Sabres in an epic Game 6. The three-overtime marathon goes down as the longest cup-clinching game in history and the second-longest cup game overall. The title was also Brett Hull's first of two Stanley Cups during his illustrious career.
4-4 tie, 7 minutes gone in overtime. Inning. Pass right on the stick of Tonelli. Coming in with Nystrom. Tonelli to Nystrom. He scores! Bob Nystrom scores the goal. The Islanders win the Stanley Cup. There's the hero of the day and the year in Long Island. The Islanders win it 4-2. The final game 5-4 in overtime. Two goals for Nystrom today. One that goes into the record books.
Bobby Nystrom proved to be the hero of the 1980 Stanley Cup Finals as the New York Islanders defeated the Philadelphia Flyers in 6 games. It was the first cup title in Islanders history, but certainly would not be the last. The Islanders would go on to win the next 3 titles for a historic four-peat from 1980 to 1983, securing one of hockey's finest dynasties. Don't touch your remote. It's the number one play on our countdown, and it's coming up next after the break.
gone out here in the Boston Garden.
If he uses an illegal stick, as he did,
score!
Canadians win the game in overtime again.
Well, they have just done something no other team in Stanley Cup history has ever done.
The top of the London and
I don't care how good the team is defensively as a team, that becomes man on man.
Two goals in 17 seconds from a 2-1 deficit, a 3-2 lead.
Well, often they say overtime games will end quickly. You can't get much quicker than 9 seconds.
You can't find anything more convincing than that.
Well, they like to follow the puck wherever it is, and I don't know if they can see it through that.
Those last two saves were spectacular. Fleury going over to stop another one just as the clock was ticking down.
Can possibly top that. It's been a dramatic countdown from number 40 all the way down to 2. Our number one play takes us to the Boston Garden. The year is 1970, and one of hockey's all-time greats provides a moment that will live forever.
Here's Don Ory, a shot. That's blocked by Talbot. Now Sanderson a drive, and that one whistled wide. Ory for the Bruins, tied up by Ecclestone and Berenson. Westfall rolled it in front. Sanderson tried a shot that was wide and keen and cleared a puck not out. Bobby Orr behind the net to Sanderson. Orr! Bobby Orr! Scores in the Boston Bruins! Sanderson to win the game 4-3 for Boston and to win the series 4-0.
That does it for our countdown of the top 40 moments in Stanley Cup history. From all of us here at NHL Network, thanks for watching. See you next time.